Before watching the video, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell notification icon to get the instant updates. Data's role is first of all to determine the ZEF. We have been talking about effective nuclear charge. Ab iska actual matlab kya hai? If I talk about the electrons present in the first shell, 1s, then 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d. And let's say I am talking about scandium 21, meaning the number of protons in the nucleus are 21. Now if I talk about s, the s electrons in 1s, they will be attracted to how many protons? 21, which are present in the nucleus. Moving ahead, 2s, 2p will experience the attraction again. 21 protons. 3s, 3p, 3d will experience 21. Will the attraction power for 1s, second orbital electrons and third orbital electrons be same?
No.
As we go away from the nucleus, the electrons will experience lesser attraction because of the inner shells. So the inner electrons are shielding the nuclear charge with the outer electron. This screening is called as the shielding effect. So in simple language, 1s can see all the 21 protons. Can see matlab experiences the attraction from 21 protons. But 2s, 2p in turn actually sees less than 21 protons. Third, 3s, 3p, 3d will be able to see even lesser number of protons. So effectively, they will experience the attraction from less number of protons, and that lesser number of protons is indicated by a constant called sigma, which is called shielding constant or screening constant. क्या बोलते हैं सिग्मा को? It is shielding or screening constant. Correct? So effectively, the actual number of protons would be Z minus something, which is the shielding constant Z minus sigma. And this Z minus sigma is the effective nuclear charge, which by Slater is identified by Z star. So ZEF is same as Z star, and it is Z minus a constant, which is shielding constant. Clear hai? Matlab, scandium ke liye, 1s can see all 21 protons, meaning the ZEF would be around 21. I am saying around because there is a reason. 2s, 2p, less than 21. 3s, 3p, 3d, even lesser than the value which we obtain for second shell ka electrons. Ye samjha? अब ये ZEF निकालना कैसे है उसके लिए कुछ रूल्स हैं। तो स्टेप्स क्या फॉलो करने हैं और क्वेश्चन कैसे आएंगे दोनों साथ में बता रहा हूं। लेट्स से द क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड ZEF फॉर 5d इलेक्ट्रॉन इन बेरियम। फाइंड इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज फॉर 5d इलेक्ट्रॉन विच इज प्रेजेंट इन बेरियम। तो बेरियम के लिए जो 5d इलेक्ट्रॉन है दैट्स अवे फ्रॉम द न्यूक्लियस, सो इट विल एक्सपीरियंस एन अट्रैक्शन विच इज लेसर देन इट्स एक्चुअल एटॉमिक नंबर। हाउ मच अमाउंट इट इज लेसर विल बी डिटरमाइंड बाय सिग्मा, एंड देन जेड माइनस सिग्मा विल डिटरमाइन द ZEF। क्लियर? सो अब स्टेप्स क्या फॉलो करने हैं। फर्स्ट, अगर क्वेश्चन आता है तो राइट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन। So, solution, first step mein electronic configuration of barium. Now to write the electronic configuration, I need to know its atomic number, or other way around, the placement also can give you the atomic number easily. It's a group, two element, placed in which period?
8th
period. 6th. Huh? Konsa period? कौन बोला 8th? 7th? 8th period होता ही नहीं है सबसे पहले। 8th बोला ना कोई?
7th.
Okay. Anyways, it is 6th period. 6th period is bit. नहीं पता तो आप, अभी मैंने आपको बोला कि सारे एलिमेंट्स जो है S और P के तो याद रखने हैं। S block elements alkaline earth metal, ये पहले तो observation होना चाहिए alkaline earth metal. Among them we have beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. BMC strongly breaking rules as usual. Yes, so this is second period. अब एटॉमिक नंबर लाने के लिए मैंने बोला फर्स्ट एलिमेंट का खाली एटॉमिक नंबर याद रखने का 4 प्लस 8 12 प्लस 8 20 प्लस 18 38 प्लस 18 56 प्लस 32 88 बट हमें तो बेरियम चाहिए था मिल गया. सेकेंड व्हाट विल बी द कॉन्फ़िगरेशन फॉर बेरियम आउटर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन इट्स एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट ना 6s 6s 2 बस तो आपको क्या करना है वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन कंडेंस फॉर्म में नहीं लिखना है पूरा लिखना है और पूरा लिखने के लिए क्या फॉलो करना है ऑफ बाउंस लेट्स फॉलो दैट राइट इट वी हैव 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6 4s2 3d10 4p6 5s2 4d10 5p6 6s2 and we know we have to stop here. Second, step 2 mein rearrange the subshells firstly from lowest to highest. Secondly, group S and P together. Everything else separate. Ab iska matlab kya? I'll just implement. You have to arrange the orbitals or the subshells from lowest till highest, matlab 1 to 6. Along with that, group the S and P together and D and F separate. Everything else separate. Matlab kya? Second, mein, I'll just rewrite this by arranging. So, 1s mein to ek hi hai, 1s2. Second, I have 2s and 2p. I have to keep them together to 2s2, 2p6 with a space in between. Third, mein, now I have 3s2, 3p6 and 3d10. Now in the off bow, 3d comes after 4s. But for Slater's, only for Slater's rule, I have to write them together according to the electrons in the third shell. So I have 3s2, 3p together. 3p6 है ना then 3d10 again fourth में I have 4s2 4p6 together 4d separate in fifth I have 5s2 5p6 only and in sixth I have 6s2 is the step clear I have just rewritten the configuration by grouping them together with respect to lowest to highest S and P together. ठीक है? अब third rule. Which electron are you finding ZEF for? That is a question you should ask yourself. Which electron are you finding ZEF for? So related to the question, I am finding the ZEF for the D electron. In the fifth shell, that is 5d electron. Now, why that is important? Because if I talk about the shielding, s, p, d, f, k electrons, will it shield to the same extent? No. The shielding will be higher for s, poor for, meaning the order is s, p, d, f. That is known concept. So, Slater ne uski basis pe rule banaya ki if the electron is d or f, the rule is separate. If the electron is S or P, the rule is separate. And two separate rules banata hun. This is for D or F first and for S or P. Kya rule hai? For D or F electron, subtract 0.35 for every electron in same subshell. Subtract. अब क्या है मैं बताता हूँ पहले रूल लिख लेता हूँ फिर 1 फॉर एवरी इलेक्ट्रॉन इन लोअर शेल्स अब ध्यान दो फॉर डी और एफ इलेक्ट्रॉन I have to find the shielding with respect to what? Sorry, there is no 5d electron, no? Sorry. So, we are finding the effective nuclear charge for the 4d electron. Now, if the 4d electron is in the fourth shell, will the outer shells have the shielding for the 4d electron? No. So, I am taking only the inner wale shells. Pehli cheez, samjha? Agar main 4d ko dekh raha hoon, toh ye wale electron shield nahi karenge. Agar main 6s ko dekh raha hoon, तो सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स का शील्डिंग का इफेक्ट लेना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? तो रूल क्या बोलता है? You have to take 0.35 as a factor for every electron in the same subshell. 4d has how many electrons? 10. We are looking the ZEV for only one electron out of them. So remaining nine electrons will also have the effect on that electron in consideration. How many? How many electron will have the effect? 9. 10 electron hai, main ek ke liye find kar raha hu. Matlab, yahan pe electrons in the same subshell, 9, would be multiplied by 0.35 to give a value of 3.15. Theek hai? Then, 1 for every electron in the lower shells. So, lower shells matlab ye bhi lower ho gaya. Same subshell yani D ka baat kar rahe hain. तो यहां पे क्या करेंगे 8 into 1 10 8 and 2 for ZEV of a d electron ऐसा from the question which electron are you finding ZEV for it's a d electron follow the rule which is given for d or f ठीक है अब add up all these values you will get the value of the screening constant once I get the value you will understand the concept also It is 2 plus 8, 10, 18, 28, 36 and 3. 39.15. Correct? Now, the effective nuclear charge is equal to Z minus sigma, which is Z equal to 56, na? Minus 39.15 will give you 16.85. Now, understand. The 4D electron is able to see only 16.85 protons from that position because it is away from the nucleus. मैंने क्या बोला था कि electron कितना nucleus से attraction experience कर रहा है वो उसका ZEV होता है. तो 1s will experience the maximum. It will have the value somewhere around 56. 2s 2p less than 56 slightly lower. 3s 3p 3d बहुत कम हो जाएगा, समझा? मतलब सिंपल लैंग्वेज में, the 4d electron is able to see only the 16.85 protons from its position in the fourth shell.
0.85 is proton.
It has the effect.
Effectively, so I can say there are around 17 protons which it can see from its position and experience the attraction only from 17 protons, rather than the existing 56 protons. भीड़ इतना ज़्यादा है ना? उसकी पोजीशन से because of the crowding it's able to see not all the 56 protons it's being obstructed and because of that it is able to only see effectively 17 protons so it is experiencing the attraction of only 17 protons that is the concept अब same question let's say 6s electron के लिए पूछा Find the ZEV for a 6s electron in barium. ठीक है? तो ये और ये step तो same हो गया. But now I'll apply the rule of S or P. ठीक है? The rule is 0.35 remains the same for each electron in same shell. Subtract 0.85 for electron in. One shell lower and one for every electron in second or 2 plus shells lower. मतलब उसके नीचे जितने भी इलेक्ट्रॉन हैं, just multiply by 1. Just listen now. एक पार्ट बाकी है. So I am looking at the 6s. How many electron does it have? 2. We are looking for one electron. So it will have one electron in 6s, which will be multiplied by 0.35. So it is 0.35, correct? Then lower mein ek shell lower kaun hai? 5. Usme kitne electron hai? 8. Usko multiply karo by 85. Let's multiply 85, 8, 40, 68. So it's 6.8. Okay? Okay na? Then 4, 3, 2, 1. 2 or 2 plus shell lower, just electrons add up karo, multiply by 1. Meaning you have to just add up the electron. In 4th, how many are effective electrons? 18. 3rd? 18. 8 and 2 adds up to 46 into 1 equal to 46. And this 3 values will add up to give you sigma, the screening constant, and that is 52.8 53.15. sigma is 53.15, so ZEF would be equal to 56 minus 53.15, which is 2.85. now the concept, 6s is a very loosely held electron, na? Why it is loosely held? Because it is not attracted to 56 protons. It is just attracted by 3 protons effectively. That is why the electron removal is very easy in case of 6s electron for barium. Clear? Understood how to apply Slater's rule? Khali wo do rules dhyan mein rakhna hai. And last part. ZEF for 1s electron for any element. Now 1s is the subshell which is closest to the nucleus, so it will experience the maximum effective charge. So the ZEF here would be equal to Z minus a very very small value, and this is as per Slater's rule taken as 0.3. मतलब अगर क्वेश्चन आता है फाइंड द ZEF फॉर 1s इलेक्ट्रॉन, कोई भी एक्स वाई जेड एलिमेंट दिया, द आंसर विल बी बेरियम के केस में, एग्जांपल बेरियम, इट विल बी 56 माइनस 0.3 व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी 55.7. एंड ये 0.3 का फैक्टर क्यों आता है? देयर इज सम डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द न्यूक्लियस एंड द 1s, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वो एक्चुअल अट्रैक्शन जो है 56 का नहीं होगा, उससे थोड़ा कम होगा. कितना कम? 0.3. तीन ही वेरिएशन है. बेरियम का एग्जांपल लिया, तीनों वेरिएशन बताया, फॉर द डी इलेक्ट्रॉन, फॉर द एस इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड फॉर द 1s इलेक्ट्रॉन. दैट्स इट. दिस इज स्लेटर्स रूल.